Welcome back to Let's Play Kanon Standard Edition for the PC. Last episode, we set out to do things with Makoto, I guess. Here we go. Makoto looks more relaxed than she has for a long time. She may no longer laugh, but I don't need that to tell that she's happy. Naoki takes the initiative for whatever, I can't pronounce that for some reason, dammit. Helping to look after Makoto. To any outsider, we must look like a normal, happy family. That's all I want. Now then. Well, before I forget, I don't know why, but I see that little thing over there looking a bit like the Firefox kind of thing. I don't know why. I think it's just the orange outline. I broach the subject as we turn for home. Why don't we take one of those together? Everyone looks in the direction I am pointing, toward the brilliantly lit arcade. Naoki does the explaining for me. She really is very open-minded for someone her age. Not that I dream of putting it like that to her face. Are you talking about, Naoki or Akiko? I can't quite think right now. Probably Naoki. Shall we then? Then again, I don't know. It's a good time for it. This must be about the only time of day when there isn't a girly queue for the thing. Well, I imagine that at this time it'd be a bunch of people pissed holding a kebab or something like, "Yes, take a picture!" I tug the curtain aside and we squeeze into the booth. Come on, man, no more jokes. This is serious. Hey, hey! Don't stand in front of me! It's as we push back and forth that I realize Makoto isn't with us. Hey, Makoto, where are you? She's standing a little way away, facing us, but staring into space. Of course, this is what she always does, just stand there, looking in while others have fun, waiting for everyone else to leave, and then taking a lonely photo by herself. A photo she'd treasure, a picture of a vision of loneliness. As though there were any need for that now. What are you playing at? You don't have to just watch anymore. Come on, we're waiting for you, aren't we? Hurry up, we can't do this without you. The others have caught on. Akiko smiles. We continue to urge, and as for Makoto, her face breaks into a wide smile and she patters over. The sight is almost enough to reduce me to tears. Come on, in the middle. She has emotion still, most of them may be lost, but this can arouse joy still, because she wanted this so much. She's been longing to do this for so long. All she's wanted has been to stand among a group. To bathe in the warmth and comfort of the bonds of human relationships. This tiny trivial thing has been her fondest desire. Naoki is pursuing the machine's instructions, its stylus in one hand. Oh, anything should do. I steal it and scribble on the display. Yeah. Go for it. Naoki presses the go button. We light fireworks when we get home. That was Akiko's idea. She hadn't forgotten that time when Makoto said she wanted to have them. Of course, when she said that, she was only trying to wriggle out of being punished. But it is hardly the time to worry about that. Right now, anything is fine as long as it makes time that the four of us can share. For some reason, it seems rather pitiful to be having fireworks in winter, like a banquet of scraps. Makoto is overjoyed. She runs around our little garden like a kid, carrying fireworks of all kinds. The flickers and flashes that light her face serve as stark reminders of the gathering darkness. After a while we run out, she stops and stands sadly in the gloom. Akiko lays her hand on Makoto's shoulder, but Makoto herself does not respond. She stands there, apparently hoping to be given another firework. Parties bring such sweet sorrow, however enjoyable the time is. Its supply is always limited. No moment can be experienced more than once. I play with Makoto some more before bedtime, making paper airplanes. This too is something I remember her having once said she wanted to do. We may as well enjoy ourselves in every way we can today. I don't have any proper origami paper, so I cut a couple of sheets out of my exercise book and square them off. Here's your piece, Makoto. I lay one of them in front of her. First, we fold it in half. I demonstrate neatly with mine. She tries to imitate the movements of my hands. With a rustle it folds, but not into halves. The fold is crooked and lopsided. Okay, open it up again. Look, like this, in half. I demonstrate for her again. Another rustle. It's crooked again. This can't be much of a game for her. Okay, no problem. Let's just have another go. You've just got to be careful. I'll hold it here for you. Again. This time, with my help, it somehow ends up reasonably even. Now open it up. That was just to make the line, see? Her paper is now covered in creases, to the extent that it's rather difficult to work out which the right one is. It's this one. Fold it up to that line like this. Combining our efforts, we work on, eventually ending up with a paper plane. The finished product is, to be frank, rather a crooked, wretched thing. But this is just a game. The point is to have fun, not to be perfect. Then we play with it, throwing it around. It's not even vaguely airworthy, but that doesn't bother Makoto. She just picks it up and throws it again, and again, and again. It's actually rather fun to watch, so I do. And on while my eyelids grow heavier. Waking up is always frightening, because Makoto may no longer be by my side. She's still there this morning, however. She doesn't stir even as I get up, her slow breathing doesn't change in the slightest. She does seem to have been getting very tired recently, though. She's taken to dropping off to sleep if I take my eyes off her for a moment, even during the daytime. I let her sleep. School ends. Hey! I greet the girl as cheerfully as I can. I have to bear in mind that she might not want to be involved with me any further. But I want to talk to her. I don't care what we talk about. All I want to do is share my burden, even if it's only implicit in our conversation. That's all it would take to calm me down. That's all I need to pull myself together. Hi. Amano replies emotionlessly, as usual. Are you heading home? Hi. May I join you? Oh, sure, I meant just as far as the gate, unless you don't want to. We make our way together through the school, not really talking about much. See you next time, viewers.